हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ विशन सर। दिस इज़ माय 8th वीडियो टुडे। टुडे आई विल टीच यू द व्हाट आर द क्रिटिसिज्म ऑफ द लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज़ द लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी, एजम्पशंस, एक्सेप्शनल्स। ओके, now what are the criticism? Criticism means what? Criticism means shortcomings. Criticism means drawback, loopholes. Okay, so in this law of DMU, it was criticized by many economists like J.R. Hicks and Hanshen. Another economist criticized this law. The law of DMU, developed by Marshall, Dr. Alfred Marshall, but this law has many criticism. Means many people are not satisfied from this law, so they start criticizing this law. Yes, let us see one by one. There are many criticism of the law of DMU. First is unrealistic assumption. Second, cardinal measurement of utility. Okay. Third, indivisible goods. Fourth, constant marginal utility and a single want. Let us see one by one. According to the criticizer, the law of DMU is not based upon any real assumption. It means according to them, the assumptions are unrealistic. Means they are not happening in reality. They are not appearing in reality. Yes, for example, homogeneity. Yes, according to this homogeneity. Homogeneity means what? The goods which are available in same color, same size, same taste, everything is same. But this law is saying that, this assumption is saying that the assumption of homogeneity is not realistic. Means it is unrealistic. Why? Because some commodities are available in the market in a heterogeneity. Means some, suppose for example, apples. So when the consumer purchases the apple, so in that bulk of apple, there are many small apples, there will be many big apples. Okay. Means the size of commodity is not same. It is heterogeneous. It means when the consumer is very hungry, so he will start eating the apple without looking that each and every commodity is like a homogeneous. So when the person is very hungry and he start eating first small apple, then big apple, then again small apple, again big apple. Yes, so this law is not valid in the case of homogeneity, because some commodities are available in a different shape, different size. Okay, second we can say means after homogeneity, continuity. The law is saying that the consumer should consume the commodity continuously, one after another, without any time gap, without any time interval. Okay. But in the criticism, the continuity is not a real assumption. Because some commodities are there, the consumer have some gap between the consumption, some time interval. Okay, means consumer will not consume the commodity continuously. Suppose first apple is very sweet. When the consumer consume the commodity, the first apple is very sweet. Second apple is also sweet. But when the third apple is not sweet, the consumer will stop consuming the commodity. So when the consumer stop consuming the third apple, so there will be automatically there will be the time gap. Yes, so this assumption is also not valid. according to the criticizer. Okay. Fourth in the sense, after that constancy. The law assumes that there will be no change in income, no change in price, no change in taste, no change in habits, no change in everything. So everything will be constant. But in the according to the criticizer, the constancy is not a realistic assumption, because the income of the person changes accordingly. Means some person is having more income, some person is having less income. So those who have more income, they will purchase the superior quality products, and those who having less income, they will purchase the inferior quality products. So income cannot be constant, it is changes as per the time to time. Okay. Rationality. The rationality is also one of the assumption of DMU, but according to the criticizer, it is not realistic assumption. Okay. Sometimes the consumer consume the commodity even he does not want to purchase, or he does not want to consume, because a hungry person that time he just want to satisfy his utility. So rationality is also one of the unrealistic assumption according to the criticism. Okay. So all these assumptions are unrealistic. Let us see the second cardinal measurement of utility. According to the law, Dr. Alfred Marshall assumed that the utility can be measured in terms of numbers, that is cardinal measurement is possible. Okay. That's why he has given one table. In that table, the number of apple given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and how much MU derives 10, 8, 6, 4, okay, 2, 0, minus 2. So all these are expressed in terms of numbers. Okay, expressed in terms of numbers. So this is the cardinal measurement of utility. But according to the criticizer, the cardinal measurement of utility, to measure the utility is not possible, because utility is a psychological concept. It is changes from person to person, because every person is different by their nature, different by their thought, different by their taste. So we cannot measure the utility by cardinal measurement. Okay. For example, a person after the drink of 4 glass of water. So how we can measure his utility? We can just count the glass, number of glass, 1 glass, 2nd glass, 3rd glass, 4th glass. But how much he gets the satisfaction? We cannot measure his stomach by having some scale. So utility cannot be measured in terms of cardinal. But somehow, some extent, Dr. Marshall has suggested the cardinal utility. Okay. So cardinal measurement is again unrealistic assumption. Number third, indivisible goods. This law is also assumed that the goods are consumed by the consumer. It should be divided in a small piece so that the consumer can quickly consume it. But in this criticism, the law is not applicable to the indivisible and bulky goods, because some goods are available in the market and the consumer have to purchase individually, means single purchase. Yes. For example, we cannot purchase the television or refrigerator in a bulk. We have to purchase individually, because it is used single. Television, we can watch. Yes. Refrigerator, we can use a refrigerator. Yes. So these goods cannot be divided. Television we cannot divide. refrigerator we cannot divide. Okay. So this law is not applicable, means this law is not valid to the indivisible and bulky goods like refrigerator, car, television sets, etc., which are normally purchased in a single unit at a time. Okay, correct. Okay. So it is again criticism of the law of DMU, that is indivisible goods. Fourth one is constant marginal utility of money. The law of DMU assumes that the marginal utility of each unit of money remains constant. But in the criticism, it is argued that MU of money is differ from person to person. It means the marginal utility of money cannot be zero. It never be zero, because the marginal utility of money differs from person to person. For example, for the poor person, the marginal utility of money is high, and for the rich person, the marginal utility of money is low, because there are different people in the society. Okay, sometimes the marginal utility of money is influenced by change in stock of money. Okay, so the rich people have less use of money, and the poor people has more use of money. So it cannot be constant. Different people have different marginality of money. So this law is not valid in this case. Number 5, a single want. Yes, the law assume that the commodity, the consumer should commodity in such a way that the commodity satisfy the single want at a time. It is also unrealistic assumption. Yes, because many commodities are having multiple uses. Okay, many commodity has multiple uses. For example, electricity. So with the help of electricity, a person is watching television and a man is watching television, simultaneously he also charging his mobile phone, and at that time AC is also on, fan is also running, refrigerator is also running. So at the same time the consumer satisfy many wants, but the law assume that the single want. So again, it is criticized by many ways. Okay. The law is restricted to the satisfaction of a single want at a time. However, in reality, a man has to satisfy many wants at a time. Yes, a man is, for example, I have given already, that is electricity. A man is watching television. Yes, a man is having charging, the man is having watching some other videos. So what is this? So at the same time the consumer getting the satisfaction from various sources, that is electricity. So this law is not valid in the case of single want. So all these 5 are the criticism of the law of diminishing marginal utility. Okay, now let us move towards the next question. This type of question come for the short notes. Explain the significance of the law of diminishing marginal utility. Significance means importance. Means this law is how much important for the consumer, how much important for the government, how much important for the paradox of value and how much it is important for the basis of law. Okay, so let us see one by one. There are 4 points of significance of the law of diminishing marginal utility. Number 1, the law of DMU is useful for the consumer. The law of DMU is useful for the government. The law of DMU is also useful to understand the basis of paradox of value, and the law of DMU is also important to understand the basis of the law of demand. Okay, let us see one by one. First, useful to the consumer. Now we can see today's consumers are very rational, very active. Means before going to purchase the commodity, the consumer think about the product. Yes, how to purchase, how much to purchase. Yes, if I purchase this commodity, how much I will get the satisfaction from this commodity. So this is called as rationality. So this law of DMU will guide the consumer. Before going to purchase, the law is guiding to the consumer how to purchase, how much to purchase. Means how the consumer will spend his money on the commodity to get the maximum satisfaction. Because ultimately the aim and objective of the consumer is satisfaction maximization. So how it's possible? So this law of DMU will guide to the consumer how to spend the money on the commodity so that the consumer can obtain the maximum satisfaction. That is the maximum point of satiety. Okay. So this law creates awareness among the consumer to obtain the maximum utility from the limited resources. We all know wants are unlimited and resources are limited. So how to utilize the resources? It is necessary to diversify the consumption. Diversify means the consumer should diversify his consumption by purchasing different commodities at a different price. Okay, so what I said in the beginning of this point, a rational consumer always think about the utility maximization by spending money on that, because the consumer have limited budget. So how the consumer will spend on different commodities? So when the consumer spend different commodities, it is called as diversification of the consumption. Okay, so this law is also guide to the consumer to how to use the money and at what commodity it should be purchased. Okay, so that the consumer get the maximum satisfaction. Okay, student. Second, the law of DMU also useful for the government. Okay, so who is the government? The government is a representative of the country. Yes, government is a representative of the country. The role of government is to take care of the citizen. But how is it possible? Yes, it is only possible when the government collect tax from. Okay, student. So the second importance of DMU is it is also useful for the government. Who is government? Government is a person who frame the taxation policy for the public, because the role of government is to collect the tax from the public and give the expenditure on the public, to spend money on the public welfare. So it is a role of government to collect the tax from the public. So the law of DMU is also important for the government to frame the various taxation policies, such as direct tax, indirect tax, progressive tax, trade policy, pricing policy, etc. So this law is also guide to the government how to tax, how much to tax, whom to tax. Because in the society there are many types of people are living, rich people and poor people. So government should impose more tax on rich people and less tax on poor people. So it is called as progressive tax policy. So this law is also guide to the government how to tax, how much to tax, whom to tax, when to tax. Also fixing of trade policies, export import policies. Yes, all these government should get from this law, that is the law of diminishing marginal utility. Okay, the third one is the basis of paradox of value. What is meaning of paradox? Paradox means the things which is creating some confusion in the mind of consumer. Means the consumer get confused. Means whether to purchase the commodity or not purchase the commodity. It's called as paradox. Yes. So there are two values in the paradox. One is a value in use and second is value in exchange. Okay. Value in use means what? The commodity which have more use value and less exchange value. And value in exchange means the commodity which have more exchange value and less use value. For example, a water has more use value and less exchange value or no exchange value. Yes, we people need water to survive. We people drink water to survive. Without water there is no life. So the use value is very high of water, but when we exchange some commodity with the help of water, we will not get any exchange value because everybody has water in their house, drinking water. Okay. So water is having more use value because many people, almost all, everybody is using water by drinking, by other way. But the exchange value is less or no. And on contrary, a diamond, value in exchange. In the example of value in exchange, for example, a diamond has more exchange value and less use value. Yes, for example, a 1 carat of diamond is worth rupees 1 lakh, for example. So it has more exchange value. If you give 1 carat of diamond to other people, the person will give you 1 lakh rupees. So it has more exchange value. But a diamond is used by very less people, means the use value is very less, because only few people can afford the diamond because it's very precious stone. Okay, so this is called as value in use and value in exchange. Some commodities having more use value and less exchange value, and some commodities having more exchange value and less use value. Okay. So this type of confusion creates in the mind of consumer whether to purchase the commodity or not to purchase the commodity. Okay. The law of diminishing marginality also helps us to understand the paradox of value. It includes goods that have more value in use and zero or less value in exchange, such as air, water, sunshine, etc., as well as goods that have more value in exchange and less value in use, that is gold, diamond, etc. Okay. So this law is also guide to the consumer to decide which commodity to be purchased and which commodity to be not purchased. The consumer will purchase those commodity which have more use value and less exchange value, and for the rich people they will purchase the more exchange value in spite of less use value. Okay. Number 4, basis of demand. The law of demand is based upon the law of diminishing marginal utility. Yes, if I am not wrong, this is the last features of utility. Okay, student, you can just recall there are 10 features of utility. So this is the last features. Utility is the basis of demand. So same point you can see here. Yes, utility is also basis of demand, means the law of diminishing marginal utility also guide to the student to demand for the commodity. Yes, and usually when the consumer demand more, when the price is less, and the consumer demand less when the price is high. So this law will guide to the consumer, because utility is a basis of demand. For example, a pen. If the pen is satisfying the want of the student, then only the student will demand for pen. Okay. When the student make the notes from the pen, means the pen has utility for the student. So when the student have utility of the pen, then only he will create the demand for pen. If the student does not need of pen, so he will not demand for the pen. Okay. So utility is a basis of demand. Okay. The law of demand based upon the law of diminishing marginal utility. According to the law of demand, the quantity demanded of the commodity rises with a fall in price, and the demand falls with the increase in price. Correct. When a consumer purchases more and more units of the commodity, its marginal utility steadily declines. Correct. When the consumer increases the more and more demand, his MU goes on diminishes. Hence, he would buy additional units of the commodity only at a lower price. So this law is also guide to the consumer to decide their demand, how to demand, how much to demand, how to purchase, how much to purchase, yes, when to purchase. All these are the importance of the law of diminishing marginal utility. Okay, student. So that much we have seen. Okay, and the next topic of your syllabus is the same chapter, chapter number 2. The last topic is, what is the relationship between marginal utility and price? This topic is new for you people this year. Last year it was the law of equi-marginal utility. Instead of that, this year in the revised syllabus it is a relationship between marginal utility and price. So in the next video we will see this table. Okay, this lesson is shown by J.R. Hicks and R.D.G. Allen, because these two people are the main criticizer of the Marshall. Okay, and they have shown what is the relationship between the marginal utility and price, and they have suggested the formula MU upon PX. MU of X upon PX means the marginal utility of commodity X upon the price of X commodity. So that we will see in the next video. Okay, student. So I stop my lecture here. So today we have seen what are the criticism of the law of DMU. There are 5 criticisms. According to the criticizers, all the assumptions are unrealistic. Yes, cardinal measurement is not possible. Yes, indivisible goods, we cannot divide every goods like television, refrigerator. Yes, const instant marginality of money, single bond. Okay. After the criticism, we have seen the importance of DMU. Means this law is how much important for the society, for the consumer, for the government. Yes. To understand the paradox value, and it is a basis of demand. So all these are there in this chapter. So almost the second chapter is about to finish, and this next coming topic, that is relationship between the MU and price, it will take some much time. It will take more time to make you understand, because it is a new topic for this year, and we will see in the classroom. Verbally I will teach you, but you will understand this after proper explanation. So in this I stop my lecture here. Okay, thank you class.